Hello ladies and gents, I am Nodiffin and welcome back to From the Depths Vehicle Designer. In this episode, I want to be designing a small, cheap patrol ship which will ultimately be cost effective. So to start with, I'm just building the hull up and it's mainly going to be primarily wood and stone construction in order to retain its cheap status. The reason I am using stone here is that stone is actually quite heavy, so it has weight of 160 compared to wood of weight 40 in beam form, which I believe is the same weight as metal. So yes, it's weighs the same as metal. And this will give me weight towards the base of the ship and help stabilize it. So if you just build it, essentially a nice strong keel here. It's also a little bit stronger than wood, and so will actually help protect the components underneath from torpedoes. Not much, because torpedoes are very strong, but it will help definitely against some of the smaller deep water guard designs, which are actually armed with torpedoes. So the gun I'm actually going to be equipping this ship with is the one I designed in my APS tutorial. It's not a very powerful weapon. This is going to be one of two weapon systems. The other weapon system is going to be a missile launcher. So I'm just deciding whereabouts I would like to place this, because I don't want to place it right next to the AI in case, well, for when it gets blown up, it will end up destroying the AI. I just don't want to leave too much space in between, otherwise it's wasted space. So I think around about here would be good, and I am actually going to put metal beams around this to ensure that it's actually protected correctly. Does leave a little bit of a gap in between for buoyancy concerns, so I will put in an air pump just like that, and so hopefully I can make the ship be stable in its own right without having to resort to too much underprops. I am going to be utilizing some because I want to put a PID system for recoil dampening, because this gun does not have any recoil dampening whatsoever. Here we go, place several ammunition caches around the hull here. These will not destroy the ship entirely should they, well, when they get detonated. It's always a when with a ship this sort of scale. I'm not entirely happy with the armament. I have only got this at the moment. I kind of want another, probably a missile system. It's just that here I'll probably put the detections. Right, and then where do I put a missile? I might actually just put a missile turret around about here, I think. I was going to do a actual vertical launch missiles, but that would actually make this ship a little bit too long, I feel. It doesn't need to be that significant in length. I think this will actually be a nice hull height here. Yep, it was enough to cover all the engines and that. Though the engine is now complaining that it has no exhaust port, so there is that to be a little bit worried about. Place it down like so. Now I just need to design a actual turret cap for this. Good, that's looking nice there. It's now going to shape the front of the hull. So there we go, I've made the front of the hull shaped now. So it all looks a little bit less blocky. Still is fairly blocky, but that's a design of most of my ships. That's one I quite like, actually. Though I may adjust it ever so slightly as I carry on building. There we go, just added another small layer of armor there. Again, this is all wood armor, so it's practically useless. So I've just begun working on the superstructure itself. And this is where I'm going to be placing my actual detection systems. So overlay this a little bit heavier, because this is where the AI and the engine are. So the AI is here, so placing the superstructure and additional armor around here is a really good idea. So I'm going for a fairly simple setup for detection here. I have some active radar of 90 degree ones, so one in each direction, giving it a good detection there. Have some munition warning systems, because I'm going to be putting a rudimentary anti-missile system on this. Then a retro reflection detector, which gives a good detection against enemy ships, and then a laser rangefinder, which is one of the better detection systems there is. I do want to put a couple of gimbals on as well. Probably going to put one right here in the front, and one at the rear as well. Put one gimbal system here, probably the gimbal camera, wherever it is, gimbal, that's IR camera. Gimbal camera there. In the rear of around about here or so, I'm going to be putting another detection. This one, I think the actual IR camera. These are not connected to the AI yet. It's just, this is about the position where everything is going to be going. Here we go. I am now doing the final touches to the rear cosmetics here. Oh, let's just mess that one up. That one, something like that. Some props, probably only going to need a couple of small props, to be perfectly honest. This is the right hand side, so right hand side, dash over to the other ones, left hand side there. These two sections here make it look a little bit more integrated into the hull itself. Back here I can add another couple of the props. These are going to be the reverse thrust. And then all the way down here, can remove that beam. And these can be the normal thrust. I'm not going to need an altitude one at all, because this ship is, I believe, is very likely to be naturally buoyant, since it's made purely of wood. How are we doing on the cost? This is now 7,600. Actually a little bit more expensive than I was anticipating, so that's a bit odd, but it's okay, I guess. Just need to add on a couple more systems. Here you go, I've added two very small little side guns. These are actually anti-missile systems. So they will be armed with flat cannons and shoot down a small number of the missiles being fired at this ship. The front gun is going to be probably an inertial frag. And now I just need to add the missile launcher array at the rear of the ship. This is will be a turreted one though. Only missile system I actually have is these ones I refer to as the micro missiles, which are not actually particularly good, but I might still use them since they will give a nice little array. And it is quite interesting to have all these little missile launchers far, but I just think that looks a little bit janky. What I'm going to do, I'm going to replace it with a single dedicated missile turret, and it's going to be considerably more powerful than these four little things. Now, I'm not happy with this. It's too large on the rear of the ship. I think I can actually just take all that off. Take those off like so. And actually go underneath with those. And if I just put that there, move that like so, put the stagger fire on, delete these guys. I can then just put the launch pads on correctly like that. So now, all those missile launchers are in a much smaller space, and that will mean that it won't look as janky once I've added all the armor on. But before, it was looking a little bit odd. I mean, part of that is probably because I'm using wood rather than actual metal. There we go, have a little missile launcher at the back here. So this now will turn all the way around and can fire a nice little array of missiles. And I think that's about what I want to have for the ship. Just going to add probably another detection system on this rear turret here. and adjust the detection systems I have at the front and the main gun here. There we go, just adding on some actual metal detailing to the ship, because not everything, don't want it to be completely wood, otherwise it's just going to be completely annihilated by anything. Just a few blocks here and there, probably around the edge of the ship, will make it considerably tougher, make the ship seem a little bit more balanced in the positioning of the actual components. Still not very happy with the cosmetic, but I'm going to have to continue working on it. I believe it's in a almost fit state to actually do some combat testing on now. There you go. I almost forgot to add on the props, which would have been a little bit of an issue. So this customizer is going to be my actual anti-missile one. And 4 flak warheads and 3 casings. In fact, I'll go check. There we go. This is the shell I'm going to be utilizing. So it's good number of gunpowder there, base bleeder, and some frag warheads. I'm leaving them as normal. No fine cone to make it do more just general damage. But yeah, I'm quite happy with how this has turned out. Cost is a little high though. 11,000 is probably a little bit much. I might want to reduce the cost of this a little bit depending on how well it performs. So I will now save it and go into some combat testing. So here we go. I've got my ship now into the normal mode. Unfortunately, there is one thing I've forgotten to do, and that is set up the PIDs. So quickly go into control, go grab the PID general purpose, put a couple of these guys down. So I want you to set to pitch, like that and that, and you set like that to roll. Have you noticed something? I have no fuel! All these checks and nothing is actually functioning because I haven't put any fuel on the darn thing. The roll is okay, just need to have a look at the pitch. I've got hydrofoil pitch, not normal pitch. So I was only using hydrofoils, which I don't have any on. There we go, now it's stabled out. Brilliant, let's quickly resave this patrol boat. And I'll put it into some combat testing. So begin with something very basic, i.e. the Vanguard. So instantly it rolls over, destroys it with the missiles, but that is not good. That's got to be where this, due to the center of mass. Yes, it is. This boat a little bit heavier. Grab some stone beams, shrink all the blocks down. And now, let us go along the side of the ship like thus. Should have lowered the center of mass a little bit. Yep, let's load it there. Majority of hits are going to hit probably around the corners of the ship. So this will hopefully provide a nice bit of deflection. Works against the Vanguard. Still going way too far. Let's add another PID system, this one for altitude. Because although I don't need to adjust the altitude, if I set it at if I set the altitude, say altitude of 0, it should now try and maintain this level utilizing the ones it already has. So hopefully it will stop it from flying. Because it's going to try and pull itself back into the water. No, that did not work. Just massively increase the gain instead. Yeah, that does seem to be helping a little bit. Still nowhere near enough. As there we go, capsized. There we go, managed to stabilize my ship. The way I've done that is I've added some props at the rear of the ship, much like I've added them at the front. I do need to adjust it a little bit because they aren't in a very good location. That means that it, rather than it just being pulled at the front, it's also pushing down at the back, which will actually help stabilize it. So if we move it, it makes it less stable. You see, there we go, it's pulling all the way around again because I deleted that component. Just trying other ways of doing stability. I've now added a massive lead keel. See if that actually helps keep it stabilized. Because it's lying the center of mass with the actual thrusters. Still doesn't seem to be enough, actually. Now, I think I've made it more stable. Basically, I've just added more powerful props at the sides, which will keeps it much more stable. Which does seem to be a little bit difficulty turning, or is it just trying to get away from its target? Oh! I haven't set these to thruster reverse. So it was counteracting the turning forces. There we go, that's resolved that issue. It looks like it turned around and shot me. I need to set firing constraints on these things. But otherwise, seems to be doing quite well in combat. Okay, so I'm now trying to set up the firing constraints. Then I'm going to increase the marker just so I can see it past the turret. Flip azimuth constraints, and I want to go from about there all the way to there, so probably minus 50 to plus 50. That's that there. This though is only part of it. I need to set the actual missile launcher to do the same thing. This is the turret block. And now the controller, same thing again. So constrain it to fire from 50 and minus 50, flip the constraints, and there we go. It's going to prevent that from turning around and killing me again. So there we have it, all the turret constraints are set up. I will quickly save it. And now let's try against something a little bit bigger, like a calamar. The missile turns and cannot fire. Ship seems to be moving a little bit close, actually. Let's set the AI up a little bit differently. To broadside from probably about 1 kilometer. The AI is now dead. And set up to ignore salvage. Destroy enemy vehicles. And these missiles aren't actually functional yet. Ship though is now all the way up to 15k, which again is a bit too high for my liking. Let's try against a more powerful design, which won the planes. So again, the missiles are probably going to do the most work. Seems that if the plane's coming directly above it, the cannon won't turn to fire. There we go. It's now in front. And there goes the cannon, doing a significant amount of damage, really. Took out the rear there. Missiles then fire again. Edit, assigned to all. So lots of fins, thruster, one turn. Probably don't need the one turn. Probably change that to a target predictive guidance. Because it turns to face the target, I don't really need one turn element. Okay, now face something a little bit stronger, something like the Angry Chicken with missiles, because I would quite like to see how well the anti-missile systems are functioning. So here come the anti-flak cannons, took down several of the missiles. Oh, there we go. One of the ammunition stores just got hit. Can my ship survive? Doesn't look like it will. It's going to capsize. That's going to leave the vulnerable underbelly, and it's just going to be destroyed instantaneously. Actually, I'm quite happy with how it's turned out. I'm not going to make any more adjustments at the moment. It probably will need some, maybe some shields, and when I utilize it in combat, I might find that quite a few things need changing, much like when I have used my cruiser and corvette. There's only so much you can really tell in the actual designer. It's once you start utilizing them in the campaign against multiple ships in fleets that you can really tell what needs to be changed. So I think that's all. I'll leave it at this for now, and then once it's in the campaign, I'll make further adjustments and keep on upgrading it to new versions. So thank you very much for watching this episode of From the Depths Vehicle Designer. If you did enjoy the episode, please leave a like and or comment below, as it is always great to hear from you lot. Otherwise, that's it from me for now, and I shall see you next time. But until then, I'm out. Goodbye!